This conference will now be recorded.
Hi Sandeep, hi Meghla, I'm going to start session. Am I audible?
Hello.
Yes,
sir.
Okay, I'm going to start session. Welcome to DevOps and AWS training. This is Shadab Akhtar. You are watching Nexus. In our last session, we have discussed about a couple of things related to the Nexus. Nexus, it is a build artifactory repository, as we already discussed. So if you want to install Nexus on a top of the Linux virtual machine, you required a couple of things. In our last session, we have discussed about Nexus installation and configuration. First of all, you have to work as a root user, sudo user. And after that, you can go ahead with OPT directory, which comes under Linux library or Linux file system. And inside OPT directory, we want to install tar wget. Not inside OPT, we want to install tar wget so that we can extract our tar file as well as we can download the thing. And also, we already installed in OPT directory tar file. You can see this is wget for www and internet get, and this is the URL. In this URL, you can see this version, we already downloaded tar.gz file 3.152-01. And after that, you can extract tar file via this command tar-zxvf. And then you will provide a file name. And then I moved this file, I renamed this file, means in Nexus 3.152-01 into the Nexus directory. So I renamed as a Nexus, but our, you know, Nexus 3.152-01 is my Nexus version. And for the good practice, as a good security practice, Nexus is not advised to run Nexus service as a root user. So create a new user called Nexus and grant sudo access to manage Nexus service as follows. We can add a new user. This user will come under home directory in a file system or Linux file system. After that, we need to provide a sudo access to this user. So via the vi sudo command, we can open a file, and after that, we can modify. We want to give a full access to the Nexus user or root access to the Nexus. After that, we need to change the ownership and group permission to Nexus, as well as sonar type work. Sonar type work means if you are going to extract your tar.gz file, two file will be extracted. One file will be a Nexus, another file will be sonar type work directory. And after that, we are going to provide chown. Chown means ownership. Recursively, we want to change. Owner means owner name will be Nexus and group name will be Nexus. And we want to give this permission or ownership change to the Nexus directory. And after that, we want to change ownership for, you know, sonar type work directory, which comes under, you know, which comes under OPT directory once you are going to extract your tar.gz file. After that, we want to change a mode or change a permission. 7 means a read write execute permission for owner, and 7 means a read write execute permission for group, and 5 means a read and execute permission for other to the Nexus. Same for sonar type. And next, you have to open another file that is known as nexus.rc file. which comes under OPT in Access and Bin directory. Bin is ideal for executable files. So all the binaries available in bin directory, one of binaries will be nexus.rc file. Once you will open this file, you will find run as user. So you have to uncomment it first. After that, you have to give in double quotes nexus and uncomment the user as run as a user parameter and set nexus user. In my case, I already done this kind of things. And after that, you have to create a service. Once you are going to start your virtual machine, then the Nexus user will be active. Create Nexus as a service. So we are going to create a service. So you can use ln command. Ln command for the make links between files. So we are going to give hyphen s flag. This is for symbolic, for make symbolic links instead of a hard link to this OPT Nexus bin directory. Inside a bin, there is a Nexus to the etc. init d initialize daemon and then nexus. So once you are going to start your server, your nexus service will be active. And after that, we, as a good practice, you have to work as a nexus user, not a root user. This time we are going to switch from our root user to the nexus user. And after that, you need to enable the nexus service. If you are going to enable nexus service, so service will be active. Now sudo systemctl enable nexus, and then you are going to start your nexus. So you can double check, we were facing issue in a last session. So you can see here it is showing active failed. So prerequisite sites for nexus, we required a Java. So in the last session we tried to install a Java. We already successfully installed Java. So once we check our Java version, it is showing 11.0.13, but still we are facing issue. So what we are going to do next, we are looking for this issue. We have to resolve this issue. We have a Java on a server, we have a Nexus on a server. Let's see next. Means I want to resolve this issue, why my Nexus is not running. So via this command, sudo systemctl status nexus, same command we can use for a start. Let me copy and then paste here. This command we can use for check status, as well as this command we can use to start Nexus. Start Nexus. Nexus is for build artifactory repository, and then you can see this is command, and we can give here in place of status we can give start. Okay, and if you want to stop Nexus, so we can go ahead with this next command. This is for stop, and now we can go ahead with the same command. See, I'm just going to paste here. I'm just going to copy and then paste here, and in place of start I can give stop. Okay, now I want to move forward. Let's see in AWS. So we have already virtual machine for Nexus. I'm just going ahead. This is my AWS account. I want to proceed with my AWS account this time. I'm gonna click on sign in. Go ahead, I want to close it, and I want to go ahead with new tab, aws.amazon.com. I want to go ahead with sign in to console. Let me go ahead this time. I'm just going ahead with my personal account. I'm going to click on next. And this is security checks. I want to follow the security checks. Now I'm going to click on submit. And this is super secret password. I'm going to click on sign in. I want to proceed with EC2. EC2 stands for Elastic Compute Cloud. It is a virtual server in a cloud. And I want to work with this server. Let's see, it is under process. Now, what I'm going to do, I want to close it. And I want to connect with this server, Nexus server, and I want to start this server this time. Let me go ahead. I want to restart or refresh. It is in pending state this time. It will take time to be start. Now I want to go ahead and I want to connect with this virtual machine. This time I want to go ahead with partition and EC2-user@IP address. I'm going to click on plus sign, then authentication, then appearance, and then change. And I want to go ahead with 12 size, then okay, then open. Now I'm successfully connected with this virtual machine. And I want to proceed now. This time I want to show you, first of all, I want to switch to the root user sudo-i. And then I want to go ahead with OPT directive, which comes under Linux file system. Inside Linux file system, you can see there are two. I want to especially focus you on Nexus. This is 3.15 Nexus. See, this is Nexus, and this is Sonar type work. So I change ownership as well as I change permission. Let's see. I'm just going ahead with the command, ll command. And let me go back to the previous directory. And now ll command and opt directory I want to check. If you'll focus, I change ownership in the last session as well as group name for Nexus. And I already changed a permission, read write execute permission for owner, read write execute permission for group, read and execute permission for other 775 permission. Same permission for sonar type. In a sonar type, I give a permission. First, I change owner name as well as group name. Ch own command we can use, and ch mode command we can use to change a permission. Read write execute permission for owner, read write execute permission for group, read and execute permission for other. So 775. So these kind of permission I already give. Let's see the next. Now again I want to go ahead with opt directory. There is Nexus and there is bin directory. In a bin directory you can see, so what changes I did, I created one user and I changed this file. Let's see this file. I'm just going ahead with VM editor, nexus.rc file. In this file, I uncomment as well as I give a nexus here. Let's see, I'm going to save this information. And then I want to switch to my Nexus user. So I already created a user. You can double check in a home. In a home directory, you can verify two users. One default user, EC2 user, another user is Nexus. So for a best practice, you have to go ahead with Nexus. Now I want to move forward this time. I'm just going ahead with the user this time. So I want to give sudo and then su hyphen username Nexus. I switched to root user to Nexus user this time, and let me try to start. I'm just going ahead with same opt. Okay, so I'm just going ahead with opt and then Nexus, then bin directory, and I want to use command dot forward slash, or we can use sh dot forward slash Nexus, and then start. Let's see if it is going to start or not. So we are facing issue. We have to resolve this issue. This is our responsibility as a DevOps engineer to resolve these kind of issue as soon as possible. So let's see, this is another command to start Nexus. So you have to, you should be in correct directory and then you can proceed. Let's see, correct directory means you should be in a bin directory. So inside a bin directory, you can run this command because there is a shell script. So I'm just going ahead with bin, and inside a bin, I give this command to start. Showing no suitable Java virtual machine could be found on your system. The version of the JVM Java virtual machine must be at least 1.8 and at most 1.8 dot. Please describe the installed 4J Java Home 2.2 suitable JVM. So it means Java is not correct. Last session I already shows you we are using a Java 11. So I want to change, or I want to install Java 8. So what I'm going to do, I want to download RPM for 1.8. So let's see. I'm going ahead this time with my virtual machine. In this virtual machine, first of all, I want to remove Java. So how I can remove? Sudo yum and then remove. I want to remove Java. So sudo yum yum remove and then Java all and hyphen y for yes confirm. So this command is for remove Java. I would copy this command and paste on notes. So remove Java from virtual machine. So I want to remove this Java. I want to give this command this time. Okay, let's see. I'm just going ahead and run this command. I want to copy and paste on my server. So this is the command already. I'm just going ahead. You can see complete. If you'll focus here, showing here a resolved dependency and removed. If I will check this time version, so Java hyphen version, you can see Java command not found. It means Java removed successfully. Let me install a Java. I have my personal notes. I'm just going ahead to my personal note and I want to show you. Let me go ahead with D drive and then see here. I'm just going ahead with my Java and you can see here. Let me check out issues environment. There is a way. Okay. Java deep dive. Yeah, this is for Java deep dive. So if you want to install Java, go ahead with sudo root user. It will be better. Java installation. I'm just going ahead with login as a root user. First of all, I want to login as a root user. And after that, from the root, I want to go ahead with opt directory. Inside OPT directory, I want to, you know, this wget is already available. I want to download. This is RPM. So let me go ahead with, this is for install wget, and I would go in end and press enter. So this time I'm going to copy RPM. Let's see. I'm just going to copy RPM for Java. And if you'll focus, I'm just going ahead with showing Java RPM. This is the Java RPM. And after that, what I'm going to do, I want to install Java via this RPM. Let's see now. I'm going ahead with this command. I want to install Java. Now process is complete, and let's see now. If I'm going to give command Java hyphen version, so showing here a Java 8. This time we are working with 8. So you have to follow these steps. So now I'm just going to copy and paste this information on a notes so that you can go in the right manner. So this is for Java. You can install the Java, and after that you can check a version. This time we are using Java 8. I'm just going to copy and paste this information so you can follow in a right manner. Now let me go ahead and I want to start again. So first of all, I want to switch to user, sudo su, and then nexus. Okay, now fine. And let's see, this time I'm going ahead with cd opt, and then this time nexus, and then bin directory. Let me start now. Sh dot forward slash nexus, and then start. Nexus is start. Starting nexus. And if you'll see this time again, you can verify by the ps hyphen ef and then pipe sign, and then grep nexus. So you can see nexus is working in various ways. Right, let's see. I'm just going to copy and paste this information. It will be helpful for you. This information I want to keep on a notes. Okay, now next, see via the PPT. I'm just going ahead with my PPT this time. Now next thing, if you want to create a service, so we can give this command, right? Let's see now. In the last session we stuck here, so I'm going ahead with this, these commands. So these nodes already available. I'm just going ahead again with this here. So this time I'm just going ahead with this command. Right, I'm just going ahead. I want to create a service. So why? Because I want to I want to go ahead with sudo, because once I will start, file exists, already exists, right? So I'm going to create a link. And then let me check out now, enable an access. Executing. And then I want to already start, right? So I want to check its status. I'm just going ahead with this time. I want to check the status of Nexus status. So enable. Status, service is running, right? Service is not creating. Okay, let's see. Now next time I don't want to create this time service. I'm going ahead with next. So what do you have to do? You have to go for browser. And you need a server IP address. This time, how to start Nexus server on a browser. So in browser, we need a public IP address, right? So here is option. So access the Nexus server from the laptop or desktop or your AWS virtual machine to the browser, http://, and you have to provide IP address of server, and then 8080. IP address you can give, or you can give host name. And let's see now, username will be admin and password will be 123 by default. You want to change, you can change. See, I'm going ahead this time. This time I want to move forward. Default port number will be 8081. Now, default Nexus port number. Default port number will be, you can go ahead with HTTP. And then colon://, and then server IP address in this case, server public IP, and then you can go ahead with colon 8081. This is the default port. So in our case, this is the syntax, and now I want to go ahead with example. And in example, we have to provide IP address, right? So I want to provide IP address in our case. I'm just going to copy and paste in place of this server. So I can go ahead with public IP address of this server. So this time I want to delete it and I want to come onto the server. So for public IP address, Meghla, what is the, how I can get a public IP address via the command? Meghla?
Sir, HTTPS :// IP address.
No.
Double.
Sandeep.
Hello.
No, Meghla. Sandeep. How I can get a public IP address by the command?
Sir, in AWS you are asking, or?
by the command I must.
ipconfig.
IP config is for private IP. Sandeep. Sandeep. Okay, let's see. We have to give a command curl if config dot cu. This is the command for public IP address. I just want to copy this IP address. And then I want to go ahead. Mute your mic, please, Meghla. Meghla, can you mute your mic? Now I'm going ahead with this URL.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I'm just going to copy and then paste. So this is the new tab, and I want to paste here. You can see Nexus is working fine. So we have to wait for a couple of, you know, seconds or minutes. Yeah, you can see it is working fine. But problem with this console or GUI, graphical user interface, we are able to see thing, right? We are able to see the browse. These all are the default. And there is no gear symbol here. There is no setting symbol here. And we are directly accessed to the Nexus. So what I'm going to do next, I'm just going ahead with sign in this time. Sign in. See, as I said already, that the default username and password will be. Okay, see. So this time default user name and password for Nexus default username and password for the Nexus this time will be. See, username will be admin, and then password, and then password will be admin 123. So let's see, this time I'm going ahead with same. I want to show you this option. There is no gear option here, and there is no setting option. Let's see, this time I'm going ahead with username admin, and then password I'm going ahead with admin and 123. I'm gonna click on sign in. If you'll focus this time, you can see this is setting option, this is gear option. Now there are multiple options. It means I successfully log in. And if I'm going to click here, there are multiple options. Server administration and configuration. Right? There are a lot of things. So what I'm going to do the next, for example, if you are able, let me sign out. In the right hand side upper corner, I clicked on sign out. Problem with this GUI, graphical user interface, as well as console, I'm able to see couple of things. I can see the browse, right? I can see the welcome page. And problem here, why I'm able to see? I want to change this setting. So without login, you cannot see or view these all things. So I'm going ahead again with sign in, admin, and then password, admin, and 123. I'm gonna click on sign in. Now again I log in. Okay, and see, this time I am successfully logged in as an admin in a right hand side upper corner. This is admin option and this is setting option. In setting option there are multiple options. I'm just going to click this option. You can see there are multiple options. One of option is a security option. Okay, here is anonymous option. So at this time it is enabled, right? Allow anonymous user to access the server. I want to uncheck it and then save this information. You can see this time anonymous security setting updated. So what will happen? Let's see. I'm just going to sign out this time and see there are nothing here. I cannot see a browse option and other option. So what do you have to do to change this anonymous access? So I'm just going to go ahead with sign in and then this time admin again and then admin and 123 as a password. Now so what do you have to do? You have to go ahead with, you have to go ahead with setting, and then after setting you can go ahead with security. In security you will find anonymous so this option after security anonymous and then in this option security see in security right and then unchecked. This is for disable anonymous user access. User access. So directly nobody can see. Nobody can see the browse option and other options, right? So there is an option. If I'm going to click here is allow anonymous user to access the server. So I unchecked it. If you are going to check, you can check the here. And the next option to change password. To change password, how to change a password? Let me go ahead with this admin option. In admin option, going ahead with change password option. So how to change password? This time I'm going ahead with how to change password. How to change password. So go ahead with admin. So click on admin. Admin option. And then click on change password. Next step, click on change password. And give a password here. User is already showing admin and password. एडमिन, 1, 2, 3 एंड ऑथेंटिकेट. नाउ यू कैन क्रिएट अ न्यू पासवर्ड, देन क्रिएट अ न्यू पासवर्ड. Create a new password. So let's see. I'm going to create a new password. As obviously, don't disclose your password to anyone. I'm going to give here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in my case, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in my case, and change password. Invalid authentication ticket. Okay. So what I'm going to do here, I'm just going to give 111 at the rate. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then A, B, C. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, A, B, C. And I want to change the password. Invalid authentication ticket. Why? Let's see, I'm just going to give 1, 2, 3. Okay, 1, 1, 1. At the rate, and then Nexus. And 111. I'm going ahead here, 111 at the rate, Nexus 111. Invalid authentication ticket. Why? REST API admin user email. Admin 1, 2, 3. Change password. So I'm going to give here A, B, C, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. A, B, C, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Invalid authentication ticket. Something happening wrong. Access API. Okay, I will look into it. Okay, so it will be enough for my side for today. In the next session, we'll continue Nexus. If you have any doubt, you can ask me, please. Sandeep, do you have any questions, Sandeep? Monday, we'll connect, Sandeep. You are not audible, Sandeep. Yes, Meghla, do you have any question?
Sir, first I need to study.
Okay.
Sure. I'll refer, sure. Sir. Then I'll ask you.
Yeah, sure.
Okay, sir.
I will call to Sandeep on a mobile. I think it might be not.
Okay, fine, sir. Sir, tomorrow...
I will update you, Meghla.
Okay, sure, sir. Okay, sir. Sir, I am really sorry, sir, actually.